So hello, good evening guys. For today's template niya is payroll version 2 2021. So this template is new. So ngayon i-demo ko to. So let's start. First of all, kailangan mo pumunta sa settings. As of now, wala pa tayong logo and employee company name. Also here in report, wala tayong company name and logo and payslip. So ayan, so let's adjust this one. Yes, that's okay. So let's go to settings. So for me, mag-upload ako ng logo ko, payroll, and here's my logo. Ayan, my company name, RJT, self-tutorial, incorporated, so, para kumang, from Samonte Street, hanggay, Holy Spirit, Quezon City, so, ayan, so, 0929-576102 and save, click save back, ayan, logo mo, reports mo, let's adjust this, so back, and also your payslip, yan yung payslip mo, so ayan, payslip mo, ayan, contact number, ayan, so, let's go to on file, mag-add tayo ng employee. So, 200, mag-input ka ng employee ID, then active. So, I put my name, J, hindi pala ito, okay, Ryan J, Obrero. So, daily basics is 1,100. So, monthly basics 2,000, and 32 days. Payroll, halimbawa, daily. Sa department naman, you can add a department. Just go to the menu or this menu. This is the menu interface. So, go to 201 file. And then here, may mga department. Halimbawa, mag-add ka ng additional department. Halimbawa, engineering department. Engineering department. Yan, so go back and put to one file. Meron ka ng engineering department. So, ayan. So, as of me, meron nasa tax department ako. Tax compliance. State high. Halimbawa, 2019. Date, 2/9/94. Civil status. Single. So, ayan. Ano mo lang yan, leave it blank. So, TIN. Meron tayong 12-digit number sa TIN. SSS. Put your number. Sir 9. This is my contact number. 9576192. Salary status is above minimum. So, I'm taxable. So, mag-a-add tayo ulit ng employee. So, mag-a-add tayo ng bali, tatlong employee yung i-add natin. Copy. By the way, this is an example. So, 2004. So, here, Duncan. Then, number is 1,000. Per hour. Department niya is finance. Bala na kayo kung ano ilalagay niyo. And another one. Then 2005. So yan. So Raven Ken Rodney Atres. So yan. So go back So as of now, meron tayong 3 employees available kasi yung 3 employee yung niregister natin dito. So if you select an employee then nag-resign na yung employee, just select the employee and update his ano his or her ano employee status. So separated, then you can fill the data here. Kung kailan siya, halimbawa, 9-3. Ngayon siya nag-resign. So go back here. Pag nag-resign siya, 2 available employee only kasi nawala na yung isa. Pag ni-resign natin yung isa, same here, yan. Isa na lang, so let's update ulit. So, halimbawa, active sila lahat. And then sa ano naman sa mga allowances, we have 2 allowances, fixed allowance and variable allowance. So you can edit this by simply go to settings, then halimbawa ito second meal allow. So it means allow is allowance. So if it is taxable or non-taxable, you can select this also. So save back. Yan. Second, so hindi na siya nakikita. So settings. Lagay na lang sec meal allowance. So second meal allowance. So save back. Yan. Second meal allowance. And then, same here, also here in variable allowance, go to settings. Halimbawa ito, allowance. So, save, either taxable or non-taxable, you can select this. So, ayan. Also here, also deductions. Go to settings, deductions also. You can edit this. Bawa, mag-a-add ka. Mag-a-add ka ng another deductions. Then, another deduction, save, back. So, ayan, another deduction, mag-i-input. And then, if maglalagay ka ng ano, pera sa allowances, punta ka lang sa fixed allowance. Halimbawa, bigyan mo siya ng allowance na 100 mil. Fixed allowance yan, ha. Halimbawa, 200, 300, 400. Dito is 500, 600, 700. Ito naman is 200, 300, 400. Let's say, i-design natin siya sa variable. Oops. Ayan. Didesign natin siya sa variable. So, pag nag-select ka ng employee, oops. Select ka ng employee, ayan. Lalabas siya. So, daily, halimbawa, 11 days. 11 days siyang ano, pumasok. Ayan. Magko-compute. 11 days, 2,100. Fixed allowance, ayan, 1,000. Variable allowance 0 kasi hindi ka nag-input dito. So, halimbawa 11 days. Yan. 8,000. So, available is 8,000. Either taxable man siya, ay automatic na po siya. Either taxable or non-taxable, automatic po siya sa taxable net income na mag-deduct if ever na non-taxable yung allowances. Sa deductions naman, go to deductions. Halimbawa is 200, 300, 500. Yan. Halimbawa lang po, ah. Yan. Yan. 300. Selections. Yan. Yan. So, yun. Yan. So, you can input. So, pwede ka mag-select dito. Halimbawa yung cut-off nyo, August 26, September 10, and then payroll date nyo is 15. Ayan. So, you can select 11. ayan, dito naman sa contributions, either yes or no. If no, if naka-yes, mag-deduct siya. Either semi, monthly, weekly, ayan. So, minimum yata ito. Ayan. So, yes. If yes, mag-deduct siya. So, let's put na lang semi. Ayan. Semi na lahat. It's 11. Ayan. So, ngayon, so gross niya kasi is 1,100. So, minimum siya. Minimum contributions. So, kasi, mababa kasi hours to eh. So, 11. Magpo-compute siya per hour. Pag-i-input ka na, limbawa, is 48. So, 96. 96 hours for 2 weeks. Ayan. So, ayan. Contribution mo, nagbabago. Ayan. So, pag-ibig mo, 50. Reserve yan eh. So, if either, hindi ka muna magkakalda sa kanya, you can off this one. Ayan. And then, pag okay na, yung process. Same, select report, if nandun na ba siya, 915. Ayan, nandun na siya sa report, it means okay na siya. Na-process na siya. So, let's select this. Kasi siya, eto naman, on my part, I'm Ryan J. So, diba, 11 days ako pumasok, tapos 11 days, yung allowances. So, kasi ito naka-no. So, ayan, save. Process, and then report or 9-15. Ayan. Pwede mong maglalagay pala ako ng button dito to print. Para mag-click ka na lang, print na to as your report for payroll report. So, ngayon, payslip. Huwag muna tayo dyan. Punta muna tayo sa DTR. Ayan. Kumbawa, eto naman. Automatic to. So, 9.15. 9.1. And, yan. Automatic siya. Halimbawa, si ako, pumasok ako. 08. Pwede kang magsulat dito. And, pwede ka rin mag... halimbawa, pwede ka palang mag-input dito. And, you can also upload. 012. 00. 13-00 and 17-00. So ngayon, halimbawa ako may late ako the next day, 11-12-00, 13-00 and 17-00. So calculate, I have 11 minutes late kasi 8:11 ako pumasok. So you can save this. Let's check the other employees kung may data sila. Yan. And then also, yan, recorded na yan. Wala na akong ibang recorded datas. Yan. So you can upload also. Let me show this time record. So this is my time record. Nag-input na ako. Ayan. Nag-input na ako. For bali 3 employees, ganyan yung ano niya, yung time record niya na i-upload natin. Yan yung format niya. So, close this, then you can upload time, then select yan. So kung wala pa dito yan, you have to select calculate. Yan. So, mag-ano tayo ng holiday. Ha? Halimbawa, holiday is January 3. Regular holiday. And sample lang po ito. Wala lang. Trip ko lang mag-holiday. Mag-holiday. So, ayan. Calculate. Ayan. Regular holiday on September 3. So, mag-automatic calculate siya. You can save this. Ayan. Employee DTR has been saved. So, ayan. Also the other the two employees. So ayan, but wala. Ay, iba siya kasi iba. Iba yung pangalan. So wait. Iba kasi yung pangalan, so iba yung pangalan eh. So next time i-make sure natin na ano na ganun yung ano, input natin. So let's delete this one. Delete and delete this also. So until 30. So ayan. Mag-a-adjust tayo. Kasi iba yung employee name. So employee name, copy mo to. Mhm. Medyo nagkahanga. Copy. Right click. Paste. Copy mo again. Until here. Paste. So, 8. And then, si, ano pa? Si, Tatea, copy. Magre-refer kasi siya sa exact name ng employee. So, save. Close this. Save na natin. Upload natin ulit. Yan. So, bali yan. Oops. Medyo may ano yata. Laps. So, September lang. Mag-gets nyo. Okay. So September 3. Kasi hindi niya in-input kasi nga dapat may ano to eh. Dito pala schedule to if either may ano either may schedule either may pasok o wala. If Saturday is may pasok, na walang pasok, then you can select no. If meron, then yes. Yan. So, let's save this. Save. Save natin to. Save. Also si Rodea. Calculate muna kasi wala pa tayo dito. Calculate. Then save. So, ayan. So, then select this. Yes, track DTR. Ayan, Ryan J. And automatic siya. Automatic si Ryan J na mag-co-compute. So, all you have to do is mag-input ka na lang sa variable allowance. So, check natin yung DTR report niya, time. So, ayan. Ayan. Sa line J meron siyang one holiday, pinasok niya for until 8 days. So cut off natin is until 10, September 10. So check natin yung DTR. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 days, and then regular holiday. So, one. Additional one for holiday. If pumasok siya. Kasi pumasok siya, then double pay. Yan, regular. Then, if okay na or hindi ka pa nag-input. So, ganyan natin, 11 days, 11 days. Ah, sorry, 8 days. 8 days, 8 days, 8 days. Then, process. Then, select 9-15. Ayan. Ayan, J. 8,000. So, after that, you can generate your payslip. Ang baba is 9.15. Ito, pag bulk. Pag bulk is lahat ng na-process on that cut-off. Pay date mo is September 15. Lahat ng na-process on that pay date, ipiprint niya. So, ang baba is print natin. Click natin. Oops. Oh. So, adjust muna natin ito. Kasi may... ano eh. Meron siyang medyo may crack ano niya. So, select again. Oops. Mali yung printer na na-select. Select natin is Microsoft PDF. So, select print. Set payslip 1, save, set payslip 2, save. So, kasi dalawa lang yung employee na na-process natin, so let's check our payslip. Check natin yung payslip. Check natin yung payslip natin sa download. Yan. Ito yung payslip natin. Yan. Automatic siya. Yan. 8 days, 1 days. Yan. So, before nyo pala isalang yung bond paper sa printer nyo, you can cut it already before mo siya ilagay sa printer para hindi na kayo mahirapan mag, mag-gupit-gupit pa. Yan. Kasi ito parang tatlong payslip yata pasya sa isang coupon band eh. So, ayan. So, dito naman, pwede tayo mag-select employee. If si employee nanghingi ng payslip on that previous payslip, halimbawa, September 15, pwede natin siyang, pwede tayo mag-generate ulit. Ayan. Sip. ING. So, yan, isang payslip ng kay Ryan J lang. Ayan siya. So, ayan. So, pwede pa na natin siyang sa about contribution naman, ito yung contribution table. It is editable if either magbago man o hindi. Whether magbago man si SSS ng contribution table. Pag nagbago, pwede mo siyang i-edit. Ayan. Also, here in PhilHealth, ayan yung table natin. So, sa tax naman, na medyo komplikado yan. So, kailangan mo talaga siyang yan. Kailangan mo siyang i-code ulit. So, ayan. So, if you're done, you can close the file. Yes. Do you really want to close the file? If okay ka na, yes. If not, no. If you're ready to close the file, you can select yes. Yeah. So, that's all for today. Thanks for watching the video. If meron pa kayong questions, you can message me. Lalagay ko na lang po yung mga contacts ko. If you want to avail this template. Thank you.